Like many technologies, video is exploding today on the internet, on the web. You know, when you've got your flip video camera where you can upload things to YouTube just like that, take your digital camera out, put pictures up on the web, not only pictures, but video up on the web, or with your mobile device of some kind, constantly we're immersed in video. It's wrapped all around us, right? Let's take a look at some video-based ideas for your classroom. Now, it all comes down to psychologists, right? David Osmill said knowledge is hierarchically organized, and we subsume new information under old or prior knowledge. Old information scaffolds what we are now attempting to learn, and it's these videos, this rich content that kind of makes things more meaningful and engaging for learners. So finding YouTube or TeacherTube videos that can be used for student conceptual learning, right? So students can discuss, debate, reflect, rethink all this rich media content that's out there. You know, John Bransford and his colleagues at Vanderbilt in the 1980s talked about anchored instruction, anchoring learning in existing video and creating a macro context to come back to for discussion. Before that, Alan Pavio talked about dual coding theory, learning things visually and verbally, therefore enriching the learning process so it's not just available knowledge, but accessible. Richard Mayer from UC Santa Barbara talked about the impact in multimedia theory in terms of animation, simulations, and rich media like video. You know, if you teach a course on memory, you can get John Tesh's radio show, little short clips you put in on how to improve your memory, or people with unusual feats of memory in YouTube, or authors of the book Brain Rules, John Medina, for instance, has a series of videos explaining his book. Interviews of authors are on the web you can watch. So many ways to learn content about teaching and learning, if you will, in memory, from watching video. So learn about those technologies that are available to create your own videos as well as watch existing ones. Understand the wealth of shared online video sites. There are portals on the web waiting for you to use. In fact, I've indexed 40 portals that you can use at a website called trainingshare.com resources, or go to my homepage and you'll find it. Some of these are on the list. In fact, all of these are on the list, plus 30 odd more websites you can go to, including, you know, Google Video, YouTube, YouTube EDU, TeacherTube, Academic Earth, Current Television. You know, Academic Earth indexes some of the finest videos of lectures in university settings around the world, from Yale and Harvard and Stanford and so forth and so on. MIT World, both internal professors as well as those external to MIT. Current TV, Al Gore's network, where people on the street could put up a documentary that gets watched, voted on, shared, ranked, and maybe win awards. YouTube, as I said, not only has YouTube, but YouTube EDU for over 200 universities to share content. So find ways in which you can incorporate video in your classroom. Think about the use of video from a pedagogical point of view. This is exploding, and it's not going to go away. You know, in the 80s, as I said, Bransford used Raiders of the Lost Ark movie to teach math and physics. People have used B.F. Skinner movies in the past to teach psychology and CNN clips to teach economics. This is not going away, it's expanding today. Showing a short video clip and reflecting on it. Watching someone present and then bringing that person in live to a class for a synchronous session is mind-boggling. When students see B.F. Skinner videos after reading the book and discussing them, they get blown away. They really get engaged with the content. They don't want to leave the class. When they get a current video in CNN that links to a course in economics or finance or management or nursing or whatever the content matter is, they get engaged. When they see the Winter Olympics and you can utilize that in health and recreation classes, or Yahoo videos interviewing maybe Tim Burton and Johnny Depp over the latest movie for, you know, movie production kinds of classes and cinematography classes. So if you bring in authors into your classroom setting after watching their video, async after a, you know, have an async experience and then a synchronous, it whacks them in the side of the head. Because we can now have instructors around the world coming into your classes. Berkeley professor Marion Diamond teaches biology and hundreds of thousands of people watch her from Berkeley in YouTube EDU. Do Flick has a set of videos available for engineering. TV Lesson has expert lessons on the web that you can watch. Nassau TV, not only can you watch space shuttle liftoffs, but they have tons of other educational content and channels that you can watch. Explore TV, the Annenberg Foundation has created a series of mind-boggling and illuminating videos on China and Greenland and issues of, you know, of ozone depletion or greenhouse gases or whatever, or climate change and other issues, domestic violence and so forth and so on, all available at Link Television. There's even a webcam at Antarctica. And beyond that, if you want to film your own videos or figure out how to cook a meatloaf, go to Clip Chef. If you want to learn how to run a marathon or interview for a job, go to HowCast or Wonder How To. Much advice here. Share what you're learning in terms of using videos with other people. Consider the learning theory that you're using or that could impact on your student learning. Is it using Ozubel's theories of, you know, using prior knowledge and embedding in, anchoring your instruction with video? Assign students to reflect on why they're using video. You know, students want short videos, less than 4 minutes long, and they tend to watch them from 6 to 12 at night. Things in Big Think, where famous people like Richard Branson from Virgin Airlines comes in, or the TED Talks, where you can listen to the world's youngest teacher, Adora Swiftak, or Bill Gates, or Al Gore, or whomever, in short videos, 10, 15 minutes long, that used to be secretive, and now everyone can see. People like Michael Resch from Kansas State, a cultural anthropologist, has millions and millions and millions of people watching his video, The Machine Is Using Us, and the other one he's got that's famous, The Vision of Today's Students, Celebrity Professors. Students are more likely to watch and share videos than create them, but you can have creativity as an option and let them create their own videos. I've done that. You can have them find videos and share what they find. Why not have them come in and share rich video content with the class, right? It makes things more engaging when the students have found them. When they have found them, you as an instructor should go through and make sure that they're culturally sensitive and that, you know, they're approved by you and that the links are there, that there isn't link rot. And have a backup plan in case there is. When you come in to show a video in a face-to-face class, make sure you've tested it out in the room. Make sure that they're working properly. And if you have students watching them, give them guide sheets or job aids so they can assess the credibility and quality, the authority and design of those contents, right? Have them maybe explore portals that exist for videos and share what they've learned. Reflect in a blog. Reflect in a discussion forum. Post the URLs in a summary page so maybe every week your students are watching two or three or four videos. Maybe incorporate unconventional kinds of videos like old TV programs that are available online that illustrate key concepts in your class. Rate the videos at the end of the semester. Have your students rate them so that maybe next time you delete some and add some new ones. And if it's a blended course where you meet them face-to-face, maybe start your lecture with a video to anchor your lecture. Maybe end it with a video and have them reflect on it after class. Don't simply use video. Think about how it extends the learning process, adds to thinking, critical thinking, reflection, pro and con debates over videos. Show a video on one side of an issue and on the other side of an issue. Check legal issues and copyright issues surrounding those use of videos. And if students have created them, maybe have a movie day, festival day in your class where students share what they've learned in there. But this is just a start. There's so much happening and going to be happening in the classes in the coming years, including live video conferencing, including telepresence, where it almost looks like you have the person teleported in. You know, Cisco has this teleported kinds of technologies, or telepresence, I should say, right? So we should think about the use of videos in our classroom. Think about where you're going with video, because this is what students are accustomed to. They want this rich, lively, entertaining kinds of things in their classroom. They want to connect the content knowledge in the book to the person, the actual person out there. So enjoy creating, watching, and sharing online video. Make those connections for your students solid so that they're learning the content and they get things set to them from the original sources. enjoy video in your car.